Mark Ridgell used to patrol schools as an SRO. He's also a parent of a current Guilford County student.
And it's just not a good way of maintaining order on a school campus.
Ridgell thinks Guilford County School District's proposed suspension policies are creating a danger in the classroom. The plan includes a longer appeal process for short-term suspensions, allowing students and families to turn to the superintendent if they can't agree on a punishment with school leaders.
If the principals aren't allowed to maintain order on these campuses and have to wait for the superintendent to get involved or her designee, how is that protecting students? How is that having a safe learning environment? How is that protecting teachers?
The changes could also allow students to avoid suspension.
Because as a former SRO, I know when they're not in class, they're not up to good things. That's when things get missing, people get hurt.
It's almost like suspending, but with no help or support to try and change why this child is acting the way they're acting.
School board member Linda Welburn has to vote on that policy. She has questions she wants answered.
They want me to approve a change to a policy. Number one, I don't know the impact to the principals. I don't know if it's feasible. I don't know if we need more personnel, and I don't know if there's an additional cost.
She says discipline and immediate consequences are needed, but suspension may not be the best way to change a student's behavior.
And maybe instead of suspension, maybe we can do community service for kids that instead of suspending them, they could go through our program. Why aren't we looking for strong alternatives that work instead of focusing on reducing suspensions?